Welcome to myprojectbazaar.com. Let me discuss about a process. The title of this process is Context Aware Radio Access Technology Selection in 5G Ultra Dense Network. Let me discuss about the abstract of this process. In Ultra Dense Network, there is an overlapping zone of signal coverage due to the extreme densification of heterogeneous radio access technology, which hand over the signal to among the available radio access technology from the user equipment, which is also deployed closely under coordinated and uncoordinated manner. The overlapping zone of signal coverage leads the user equipment to the frequent signal handover among the available radio access technology, which degrades the overall performance. Hence, context-aware multi-attribute radio access technology was introduced. This is proposed to eliminate the unnecessary handovers of user equipment among the radio access technology, then determine the best radio access technology as the next point of attachment among the available ones in the ultra dense network. In context aware multi-attribute radio access technology, the context aware concept is integrates with multi-attribute decision making theory. In radio access technology selection, the context aware multi-attribute radio access technology is formed with two mechanisms: the context aware analytical hierarchy process mechanism to prioritize the criteria for obtaining the weight, and context aware technique to choose the best radio access technology among the available radio access technologies. Let me discuss about the flow of this process. In ultra dense network, radio access technology is employed, which is integrated with the context aware concept and plays as a context aware multi-attribute radio access technology. This context aware multi-attribute radio access technology is employed as an algorithm. The mechanism of the algorithm is subdivided into two processes, namely analytical hierarchy process and multi-attribute decision making. Weight of the radio access technology is obtained based on their priority. With their priority assignment, this criteria is used for handover process, which is used only to know the weight of the radio access technology. In multi-attribute decision making sub-process, best radio access technology was determined based on their selective alternative, which is also used for handover process. The handover is minimized due to the mechanism, namely context-aware multi-attribute radio access technology. Based on the handover, ranking order will be analyzed, depends on their priority, and ranking abnormality also analyzed based on rank order and handover process. In this process, we need MATLAB software. This is the MATLAB R2015B software. It consists of command window, workspace, command history, and current folder. This current folder having our process coding file. This coding.m file is our process code file. Right click on coding.m file, then click run. Thus, the output was displayed. Let me discuss about the output of this process. Figure 1 shows the macrocell and femtocell scenario. This figure is about the system architecture of our process. Blue 1 represents the macro base station, black 1 represents the home evolve node base station, magenta 1 represents the typical user, and green 1 represents the Wi-Fi. Figure 2 shows the number of handover in background traffic. This figure explains about to compare with other multi-attribute decision making techniques like POPSIS, SAW, GRA, context-aware multi-attribute radio access technology, that is CMRAT, has reduced number of handover. Three shows the number of handover in the conversational traffic. This figure explains about to compare with other multi-attribute decision-making techniques like POPSIS, SAW, and GRA. Context-aware multi-attribute radio access technology, that is CMRAT, has reduced number of handover. Figure 4 shows the number of handover in streaming traffic. This figure explains about to compare with other multi-attribute decision-making techniques like TOPSIS, SAW, and GRA. Context-aware multi-attribute radio access technology, that is CMRAT, has reduced number of handover. Figure 5 shows the number of handover in interactive traffic. This figure explains about to compare with other multi-attribute decision-making techniques like WPSAS-SAW-GRA context our multi-attribute radio access technology, that is CMRET, has reduced number of handover. Figure 6 shows the ranking abnormality in background traffic. This figure explains about to compare with other multi-attribute decision-making techniques like WPSAS-SAW-GRA. Context our multi-attribute radio access technology, that is CMRET, has reduced number of handover. Figure 7 shows the ranking abnormality in conversational traffic. This figure explains about to compare with other multi-attribute decision-making techniques like TOP-SAS, SAW, and GRA. Context our multi-attribute radio access technology, that is CMRET, has reduced number of handover. Figure 8 shows the ranking abnormality in streaming traffic. This figure explains about to compare with other multi-attribute decision-making techniques like TOP-SAS, SAW, and GRA. Context our multi-attribute radio access technology, that is CMRET, has reduced number of handover. Figure 9 shows the ranking abnormality in interactive traffic. This figure explains about to compare with other multi-attribute decision-making techniques like TOP-SAS, SAW, and GRA. Context our multi-attribute radio access technology, that is CMRET, has reduced number of handover. Thank you for watching this video.